All right, hello everyone and welcome back to Kotobo's Space Program, where today we are having a look at the Alcentar Rescue System mod, which is being made by forum user Alcentar. And what this glorious little piece of work looks to add into the game is a small series of parts to hopefully let you land a bit more safely on a planetary surface through things like new heat shields, additional parachutes, all of which are very good to have, especially if you're like me, and occasionally crash. And plus, it's always nice to have a greater variety of safety equipment. So let's jump right into the VAB and have a look at what all this does have to offer us. And let's of course start by grabbing a Mark 1-2 command pod, not only for size comparison's sake, but also because since these are sort of safety parts, they will typically be attached to, say, a command pod, things like parachutes, etc. So let's then turn on our mod filter so we just have the rescue system parts, and we're to start down in the engine category with our first bit of rescue systems, and that is the SS Super Crago. And this is a fun descent engine to attach onto a command pod, lander, or anything else of that variety, and it is quite nice. It does have a built-in alternator for electric charge, has a max thrust of 40 kilonewtons, uses monopropellant at a rate of 2.79 per second, and of course has an onboard monopropellant tank holding 80, which is always good to have that additional onboard monopropellant for this engine's usage. And it is actually quite a nice, powerful engine. With four of these, you can actually take off from the planetary surface here, one of these Mark 1-2 command pods with no problem, and actually fly it around. It's fairly entertaining. And yeah, it's just a fun little engine that you can add on for any sort of descent stage to either land without parachutes, or, you know, potentially in some situations to assist the parachute if you have a bit larger of a payload. Very cool part, very nice. Now the next thing we have is going to be down here in the thermal category, where we have a selection of different heat shields. Now we have basically two categories of heat shields here, and then several sizes of each. Now the first one is the ARSLS series, and they come of course in the 1.25 meter variety and the 2.5 meter variety, and these are quite fun little heat shields that have, if we open it up, some built-in landing feet, which is always handy to have so you don't have to have additional exterior landing legs. But you also notice right here, and of course over here, it's got some little retro rockets in it. That's right, folks, a heat shield with a built-in retro rocket for, I'm not gonna say slowing your descent, but at least a, hopefully we don't have to use it, emergency safety feature. And I say it like that, which is probably a little bit weird, because even though it is quite powerful, with the 2.5 meter heat shield having a max thrust of 220 kilonewtons in a vacuum, it only has 6 solid fuel. So it will literally run out of fuel for this heat shield in less than a second. In fact, 1/3 of a second is how long it will take for it to go through its fuel. So you really don't want to use it as the only thing you rely on to slow you down, because frankly, it's not going to do it. But if you just need that extra couple of meters per second slowed before hitting the ground, it is actually quite useful as a last resort. Now, other than that, it does hold some electric charge, the 2.5 meter one holding 10 electric charge. It is, of course, a heat shield, as well as a lifting surface, and all in all, a very fun little thing. Now, the 1.25 meter version, same deal, and again, 1/3 of a second for its engine to go off, has the same lifting surface rating, and same 10 electric charge, and yeah, just a smaller version for any of your, you know, 1.25 meter crafts. But let's actually pop it there so we can at least take a look at the landing legs. There we go, nice and tiny. Very cute little thing. And as you can see, we do have a nice little shroud here, which is always fun. Now, the next three that we have are the heat shield with just the landing leg. So it doesn't have the retro rocket on it, but it will just have that leg right there. And as you can see, it comes in the 3.75 meter variety, the 2.5 meter variety, and finally the 1.25 meter variety for you to use in whatever ship. Now, why the rocket one doesn't come in 3.75, I don't know. That might just be something that will come eventually down the road, but for the time being, we just have those two smaller sizes. But yeah, so very fun things. I do love them. And again, even though the retro rocket one isn't exactly going to help slow you down a lot, it is good in that, oh god, I just need like two or three more meters per second so I don't break my ship. So yes, it is still very useful. Let's leave that on, what the heck. Now the last thing that we have here is of course parachutes, which we do again have in three different sizes. If we do zoom out a bit here, we have the 3.75, oh boy, that's a big thing, the 2.5, and the 1.25 of these inline parachutes. And these are quite fun. Now the intention for these is to be used on your first or second stage as a recovery tool for that part of your rocket that you, you know, detach off from the rest. And what they'll have is, like I said, it's inline, and at each of these parts where it has a P, a parachute will pop out. So all in all, you'll have four parachutes coming out of this thing to help whatever thing you do release, solid rocket boosters or what have you, come nice and slowly back down to terra firma, which is quite fun. Though I'll be honest, I actually do like using them for just my normal landers as well, because, I mean, they're in line, so I don't have anything bulkily coming off of either end, and unlike a typical parachute that would just fit right up on the top and then not allow me to build anymore, I could take, say, the 1.25 on this one, pop it there, and then still put something more on top. And yeah, it's actually quite a nice little parachute, and of course, it actually is technically four in one, since you do have four of them coming out of the side, which makes it quite cool. Now, that is it for the parts, so let's actually take a look at a crappy little ship that I built earlier to actually show these all off and do a little bit of testing. So we have just a normal solid rocket booster to launch us up into the air, at which point we'll then use these super Crago engines to slow our descent back to terra firma, which, as I said, at full power, these four engines will actually make this capsule fly, so we'll then fly up into the air and then release the parachutes. So there we are, that should all work. Let's go to launch and show off the Alcentar Rescue System parts. Now let us SAS on and fire in 3, 2, and 1. Lovely, a just slow descent with this kind of crappy little solid rocket booster. But oh well, that's all we really need since we are just showing these off. Drop that. And for fun, we'll open up our legs there. Very fun. And now that we are descending, activate the rockets. There we go. Now we get a nice little plume coming out of these things. We are slowing down. Yeah, not as much as I was hoping. But you know what? We can always throttle up more. And more, and actually if we go all the way up, we'll start flying back up again, and away we go! There we are, rather than landing. And yeah, they are quite nice little engines, again using that monopropellant, and we'll just cut those off and wait for us to fall once more, where we will then use the parachute. Ooh, which actually I meant to throw that right there, beautiful. And release the parachutes. There we go. As I said, four do come out. And we have a nice, gentle, slow fall to the ground now. And of course, when we do get a little bit closer, I'll activate the final engine on the heat shield. There we go, which did just drop us maybe an extra meter per second or so, but again, is sort of meant as that last minute thing. Now, it does actually look like our landing legs went through the ground there. Let's close those up and see if we can have them come back. Ooh, we got a little pop there. Perfect. Lovely. There we go. Now we're on the surface. Beautiful. That's a little weird, a little minor glitch of them going through the world, but oh well, oh well. They're here now and we're fine. But yeah, that is the Alcyntar Rescue System. It's a pretty nice selection of parts. I do enjoy them. I love the Super Crago engines. They are quite useful, and I can see myself using these on a lot of different ships and landers, etc. And I especially like that they do just use monopropellant, as it's a little bit easier if you have like a mining operation off-world to fuel those, rather than having to get both liquid fuel and oxidizer, at least in my opinion. And yeah, the fun parachute for either these first or second stage parts, or even for landers, and finally, our fun selection of heat shields. Now again, why the heat shield has so little solid fuel, I don't know. Hopefully that'll change in the future, as I'd like at least for it to burn for more than a third of a second. Come on, give me at least 1 or 2 seconds. That'd be fine. I'd be happy with that. A third of a second seems a bit much, but who knows? Who knows? It'll may or may not change in the future. But that is the parts as they are right now. So if you'd like to take a look at them for yourself, which I would definitely suggest that you go and do, you can take a look at the link in the description as per usual. But that is going to be it for today's episode, my friends. I hope you all have enjoyed and that you do come back for the next. But until that time, thank you for watching. And as always, have a good one. And now my Kerbals are going to fall to their death because I forgot to, you know, reset and they now no longer have a parachute. Well, that's it for them. Later, folks.